So we uncovered about 3 tons of artefacts. This is quite phenomenal because we haven't recovered anything of this magnitude before. We do see a spectrum of things from all over the world, depending on the chronological time period. From the 14th century, we have a bulk of items from China, India, and maybe Java or Sumatra. And later, if you move on to the 16th century, we are starting to see some items from maybe Vietnam, possibly Thailand, and a few of these other kingdoms and states around Southeast Asia. So once fieldwork is completed, we'll come back to our facility at ICS. There are many steps to follow for the post-excavation. The rule of thumb is 1 day in the field of digging equates about 21 days of post-processing or post-excavation work. So what's step one in post-excavation? One, cleaning. We wash the artifacts, keep them clean. Step two is sorting them. Sorting them in different categories, metal, ceramics, wood, timber, what have you. And we break down slightly further in different diagnostics, parts of different vessels, etc. After sorting, we have labeling or marking, inventory control, and we start giving a unique identification number for each individual artifact and pegging them to something. After we have the labeling, we will start doing the illustration, photography, and then we create the database entry of the stuff. Beyond the database, we'll start repacking and putting aside the artifacts. If we are there, at that stage, we are almost home free and you can really start the serious analysis. What do I mean by serious analysis? That's when you start wanting to look at the chemical composition of certain artifact, or I want to look at the age of certain artifact. I want to look at the certain stylistic design. But once you have the database, you can pull out all this data from there and take out the individual artifacts. So it's a long drawn process. Yeah, so we've uncovered quite a lot of ceramics. A lot of them are porcelain. Like in this case, this is one of the Buddhist figurines, a devotee statue that accompanies a bodhisattva or Buddha, not itself the deity, but one of those devotees that's sitting next to it. And we have about maybe 15 or 16 of these items, and it's quite rare in Singapore because we only uncovered 2 pieces maybe back in 2010. And here at Empress Place site, we suddenly have a whole series of them scattered throughout the entire site. An incense burner, where you put sand and you put a joystick in it. This particular example is of imperial grade or imperial quality, meaning that it's produced for use in the imperial family. We dated back to about the turn of the 15th century, you're looking at around Emperor Hongwu, the first emperor of the Ming Dynasty. Not all the artifacts are ceramics. A lot of metal coins, copper cash or brass coins, Chinese copper cash. We do find all sort of evidence for maybe even metalworking. Some of the other artifacts that we get are glass beads and glass itself, or glass bangles, but mainly ornamental in nature. The timber finds itself were quite spectacular. We still don't really know what's its true purpose. We know that at least it's been recycled from perhaps a ship or a vessel, looking at 700-800 years old, which might suggest that it's evidence of shipbuilding or evidence of the ability of someone with the knowledge of shipbuilding, Southeast Asian techniques. At some point over the next few months, we'll be extracting elements of the timber for further analysis in order to, let's say, example, what sort of species of timber? Is it local species from Singapore or Malaya or the archipelago? Or what, did it come from Lebanon? Or if it did, that's a big news. Right? So we don't know. We'll examine that. Yes, this is one of the interesting finds. It does suggest that whoever that owned it had a sense of humor. Very graphic detail of a male and a female couple in very intimate and compromising position. If you want to store something, that's a very small, tiny, and too intricate and too refined for you to store anything. So it's more of a piece where it's a showpiece, a collector's piece. So it does suggest that whoever has it has a bit of resources or maybe affluent or leisure on their time to indulge in these things. So Empress Place is really a watershed. Never before have we seen items that are suggesting that an ancient Temasek or Singapura would have continued in its existence until perhaps even the mid-17th century. So we are starting to, in a way, rewriting history.